The book's fascinating. The story is fascinating. You know, like most people, I can remember you as a little girl, mm-hmm. you know, the Sonny and Cher shows. You don't have much memory of that time, which I find very interesting.
Of when I was really little on the show, and of that kind of the picture that everybody has in their head, and you know, that I was probably two or three. No, I really don't remember that.
I want to play you a clip from the show, actually,
okay.
just to remind people who don't remember. This was you on the Sonny and Cher show.
Mm-hmm. You can be a good little angel, or you can be a naughty little devil. Now, don't
I want to be a naughty
little devil.
You don't remember that, but now you've seen it again. What memories does it bring back to you, if anything?
You know, most of the memories that I have of that time was backstage. And, you know, the way that kids have silly memories of things, I remember that we shot at CBS, and it was right near the farmer's market, and I used to like to go there and get Mexican food. And, you know, those type of weird things.
Do you remember being...
But I don't really remember being
part of a famous family.
No, not at all. That really actually didn't register at that point. And then as I got older, it did. But not really about me, just, you know, when I was with my parents, and especially, you know, my mom, just how everybody else reacted, I was, of course, aware of.
Well, what kind of girl were you as you got past that stage and became 7, 8, 9? When you can start to remember, what kind of girl were you?
I guess what you would call a classic tomboy. But, you know, what I would say was, you know, I was really a boy. I felt like a boy, and my friends were all boys, and I was really comfortable in that space in school from ages probably, you know, 6 through 10, 11. And then as I started to get older and about to head into puberty, things started to get difficult. Expectations of how a young lady should act started to creep in. And then, of course, I hit puberty, and my body just started to transform in a way that was exactly the opposite of what I wanted it to do.
But were you mature enough to understand that this transformation wasn't right for you? Or did you just feel odd?
It felt like it wasn't right for me, but at that point, I mean, I didn't know about, you know, being transgender. I didn't know that people could transition from one side. I had no idea. I just knew that something felt incredibly wrong, and what was happening to me, particularly, I mean, I was very aware of my breasts, and that they just felt wrong on my body, and that I always tried to de-emphasize them in every way, that, you know, wear baggy shirts and, you know, really try to de-emphasize them in every way that
I
could.
What's interesting to me, reading the book, at the mm-hmm. same time you're going through this extraordinary experience and the feelings that you're having, your mother, of course, is one of the world's most famous sex symbols, a mm-hmm. kind of embodiment of female beauty.
Right.
Did that make it more difficult for you?
No, I don't think it really made it. I think that was kind of incidental. I think it was difficult in that I think as a mother and during that time period, she had expectations of how she thought I was going to be, and there was friction between us because of that. But I don't think it really mattered to me one way or the other that, you know, she was a sex symbol or any of those things.
As you got a little older into your teens,